you so much, Adam. So he loves to cook. We love to cook. We all want to eat better in 2018. And we have got registered dietitian Carol Harrison back. You're saying we're eating way too many processed foods.
That's
and
right.
We have to really learn how to eat better and make it easy so we're more inclined to do it.
That's
so you're
right.
going to make one meal and we're going to stretch it out over a few days.
Yes, a no-fuss, delicious meal that has leftovers that you can repurpose and enjoy for a few different meals.
Okay,
so the way to do
great.
It. So most people think a roast is so much work. A roast is not a lot of work. I want to show it's no fuss. So it's a 3-pound roast here. You're going to season that with some salt and pepper. You're going to sear it, get it nice and brown in your pan, and then you're just going to put some pesto on it. So it's a Mediterranean style.
So you can do this with any protein, right? I mean,
oh,
a
sure
big
you
piece
could.
Of salmon, you could do
oh,
it with
why not?
Chicken.
Absolutely, absolutely. The beef is gorgeous too, but yeah, you know, think about what you have and what's on sale and what you'd like to eat.
Okay.
And going with that in the oven then is going to be some roasted vegetables. So again, we're going to use more of that pesto. About 3 tablespoons I'd put on all these veggies. And again, you can use what veggies you have on hand, what's in season. You're going to toss those up.
This is new. What is this?
Yes, this is fantastic. I love to use this. It's a Kukina reusable nonstick baking sheets.
Smart.
So it's
less
quick
waste.
Cleanup, less waste. You never need parchment ever again.
How long are we baking these?
Okay, so both of these are going to go in the oven at 275 for an hour and a half.
Okay.
And that's it.
Slow roast.
Slow roast. It's so delicious. So this is what you end up with. Fantastic veggies and a beautiful roast and lots of meat that you'll have for leftovers.
Nothing tastes better than the veggies that are roasted. It's caramelized. They almost taste like candy. You will love them.
Fantastic.
Your kids will love them. I know you have 3.
I do have 3 kids. Make a big sheet pan of roasted vegetables.
Okay.
There's so many ways you can use them. So you've got your roast. And, of course, this is calorie-wise and nutrient-packed. One serving of beef has less than 200 calories, 26 grams of hunger-curbing protein.
And you're saying we need to eat more protein.
Yeah, we could benefit from eating slightly more protein throughout the day. That's right. Canadians eat on average on the lowest end of the recommended amount of protein.
Which is?
Which is about, 15 to 30% of our calories. So that's a, number that's kind of confusing. What I like to tell people is make sure you get your protein breakfast, lunch, and dinner and look for about 20, 30 grams per meal. And that's what you're going to get with this beef. So what can you do with it for leftovers? You can make a gorgeous sandwich. And again, you could have a sandwich bar at home with your kids and they could top it with whatever they want. So we've got our roasted veggies that's on there. We add some beef. Maybe you like some sun-dried tomatoes that you can buy this at your deli. Add a little more flavor. Maybe you want to put olives on it.
What was your dip on the bun?
Okay, that's taking, again, the pesto. It's very clever and adding a little bit of mayonnaise to it.
Stretch it out. And then look how pretty this looks when you're heading to work or school or you just need something in the fridge that's ready to go.
Take the roast, the vegetables, and in it goes. Again, you want to add some beef on there, some extra salad greens, some feta, maybe roasted tomatoes.
Beautiful.
What a gorgeous, gorgeous lunch.
And you made your barley in the rice cooker.
I did.
Smart.
Yes. Same ratio as rice. 2-to-1. Easy peasy. Soup. Add some tomatoes, some broth, canned beans, all of these delicious leftovers, the beef, the roasted vegetables, and maybe you want to turn your leftovers into soup.
Hearty and comforting in the cold, right?
That's right. Today, a day like today would be perfect.
How long will all this last, the roasted veg?
So two or three days is a good ballpark for most leftovers. Think of 2 or 3 days. It's the least complicated way to think about using up leftovers.
And once you've done the cooking and you've cleaned it up, it's so much easier to repurpose. And you're saying, when in doubt, make an omelet.
On the
weekend,
big
frittata.
Gorgeous frittata, which is, basically an omelet. Another way to use up, you could put these roasted vegetables into that frittata. It's another cook once, eat twice. It's a great way to work smarter, not longer in the kitchen.
I love eggs for dinner. You can have that with a salad or put it in a sandwich and you could take it to work for lunch.
Easy, quick breakfast, too.
For more information, everybody, yummylunchclub.ca. Great ideas.
We'll
be back with more BT right after this. What else did you put in here? This is the basil.
So raise your glass if you